We have the sales data of a company in this worksheet. And I have 5 questions to answer after analyzing this data. They are: sum of sales done by each sales rep, sum of sales for each product, sum of sales for each region, total number of units sold for each product, sum of sales for each product done by each sales rep. Using pivot table option in Excel, we can find the answers to all these questions in a couple of minutes. For creating a pivot table, select a cell in the source data. Go to Insert tab. Click on Pivot Table. Now we have a dialog box saying Create Pivot Table. Here we have to specify the source data. In this case, Excel automatically detected the source data. That is the range from A1 to G101. Now we have to specify the location where we want the pivot table to be placed. I want the pivot table on the same sheet itself. So I will select existing worksheet. Now I have to specify the location. I will select the cell I9. Click OK. And we have our pivot table here. Name of this pivot table is Pivot Table 1. To build a report using this pivot table, we have to choose the fields. For finding out the sum of sales done by each sales rep, I will drag this field Sales Rep into the area for rows. Now we have the list of sales rep. For sum of sales, drag this field sales into the area for values. And that's it. This report which we created using pivot table is the answer for the first question. That is sum of sales done by each sales rep. Now the second question, sum of sales for each product. I will copy this pivot table. And we'll paste it here. The copied pivot table is automatically named as Pivot Table 2. Now I will unmark the checkbox for sales rep. We'll drag this field product into the area for rows. And in this second pivot table, we have the answer for the second question. That is sum of sales for each product. For the third and fourth questions, I will copy these two pivot tables. And we'll paste it here. And they have become Pivot Table 3 and Pivot Table 4. Third question is sum of sales for each region. We'll unmark the checkbox for sales rep. Drag this field region into the area for rows. And that is the answer for our third question. Fourth question is the total number of units sold for each product. In this case, we have to make the change in the area for values. Unmark the checkbox for sales. Drag this field units into the area for values. And that is the answer for our fourth question. Fifth question is a bit difficult one to answer using formulas. Sum of sales for each product done by each sales rep. But with pivot table, it's just a matter of drag and drop. I will copy the first pivot table. We'll paste it here. Now I will drag this field called product into the area for rows. And this pivot table is the answer for our fifth and last question. Here we have the option to expand and collapse the details. To collapse the details listed under each sales rep, right click, move the cursor over Expand Collapse, select Collapse Entire Field. Here from the design tab, we can choose the formatting for these pivot tables. For modifying the design, select a cell from the respective pivot table. Select a style from the pivot table styles. Now about the advantage of using Excel table as source data for pivot table. I will create a new sheet here. We'll copy this sales data into the new sheet. To convert this data into an Excel table, select a cell in the data range. Go to Insert tab. Click on Table. Excel has automatically detected the range that is to be converted into a table. Click OK. This data range is now an Excel table called Table 1. To create a pivot table from this Excel table, click on Pivot Table under Insert tab. We have the dialog box for Create Pivot Table and source data is Table 1. Now we have to specify the location of this new pivot table. I will select this cell J3. Click OK. And this is our new pivot table called Pivot Table 6. For finding out the sum of sales done by each sales rep, drag the field sales rep into the area for rows and sales into the area for values. Now back to our first sheet where the source data is a normal data range. I will add a new record here. A new product months. Region will be East. A new sales rep named Tony. Units will be 200. Price will be 450. And if we look at the pivot tables here, the addition of a new record has no effect on it. We can try the refresh option with pivot table. For that, go to the Analyze tab and click on Refresh. Still, the data remains the same. Now let's repeat the same procedure in the second sheet where our source data is an Excel table. No changes in the pivot table until now. But when we go to the Analyze tab and click on Refresh, the pivot table got updated and the sales details of the new rep, Tony, is shown here. As Excel tables are dynamic, that property will be inherited by pivot tables which use tables as source data. One more great feature of pivot table report. Here in this report, we have the sales data for each sales rep. For extracting the data behind each figure, you just need to double click on it. This action will create a new sheet which contains the exact data that was used to calculate the sum of sales. Once again, with the product called Bounty. I hope you will find this video useful. For feedback and discussion, please make use of the comment section. And those who are visiting this channel for the first time, subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon so that you won't miss anything. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.